Marvel friends, it's the Mighty Marvel Show, and it's me, Paul, and we've got another in our series of Marvel must reads. Now, we've done some classic Marvel comics tales in some previous episodes. You can go and have a look at those. They're on our channel now if you've not had a look at those already. So we've got a classic today, and I thought, what better timing than to tie it in with the Falcon and Winter Soldier series that is airing right now at the time of recording this on Disney Plus, which is awesome, by the way. So the story we're going to look at is this beauty, the Captain. What's that? Two captains, Captain America losing the shield, losing his costume, a new Captain America called John Walker coming in. Does any of that sound familiar? I'm sure it probably does. That's the premise of some of the story in the Falcon and Winter Soldier, and that's really obviously about Sam Wilson looking at the legacy of the shield. He was offered the shield by Steve at the end of Avengers Endgame, for those who have seen it. Oh, spoilers, too late. I'm sure you've seen it. And the story of the Falcon and Winter Soldier is the government appoint a new Captain America in John Walker, who has a partner, Lamar Hoskins, same as in the comic book series here. This is the original trade paperback print, all of the issues. Talk about that in a minute. And it's therefore obviously about, is this Sam's journey to take the shield of Captain America? You know, how do we view John Walker as a new Captain America? Is he going to be accepted by people? So that's the story going on there. A lot of similarities. Also in that story, you've got the Flag Smashers coming as well. So that, again, something through this comic book. But let's talk about the comic book series today that it's very based on. Now, as we know, Marvel Studios like to cherry pick a lot of the best source material and build their own stories rather than do direct adaptations. So that's what we've got going on here with the Falcon and the Soldier. In terms of the original storybook, so Captain America No More. So this covers issues 332 to 350, right back in the mid-1980s. Written by Mark Gruenwald, with art by Kieran Dwyer. I've got all the original versions of those safely locked away, so here's the original trade paperback print version. Fantastic story. The premise of this story is a government organization, a government department called the Commission, feel that Steve Rogers, Captain America, should be working for them. They say they created the Super Soldier Serum, they created the whole principle of Captain America, and that gives Steve a dilemma over, you know, who is Captain America? Is it the government? Is it him? Is it the shield? Is it what it stands for? And so he spends that first issue really sort of deliberating that, talks with a lot of his close friends and confidants, you know, the Avengers, Sam, who's obviously Falcon at that stage. And he decides to actually walk away from being Captain America. He feels that, you know, it's what the government want is not for him. It's not for him to be an agent of the government. He doesn't represent the government. He represents, you know, the American dream, the American ideals, freedom and liberty and all those types of things. So he steps away. So he walks away from it. This leaves the government difficult position. So they appoint John Walker, as they've done in the Disney Plus series, to the role of Captain America. Now, the differences with John Walker in this comic book series is John Walker was at that point a enhanced individual that had received augmented super strength from the Power Broker. Sound familiar? Yes, because the Power Broker is a shady character in Falcon and Winter Soldier series, who at the point of recording this, we've not yet seen. So he already has powers. He goes under the guise of the Super Patriot, and he's very much the sort of, you know, ultra conservative, ultra what he feels represents, you know, the American flag, and very much more that sort of aligned to what that government are looking for at that time. So they offer him the role, he accepts the role. He gets some training from Taskmaster. You can just see it on the end over there, Taskmaster. Trains him in the use of a shield. And he takes on the Captain America costume, the Captain America mantle, accompanied by his partner, Lamar Hoskins, who at that stage is known as Bucky. And he actually becomes, let's find it in the comic book here, he actually has the Bucky costume. Let's see if I can find that quickly. So there we go. So you've got the original, as Bucky Barnes was in the comics, got the original costume in partnership with John Walker, Captain America. Throughout this series, Lamar evolved to his own character, actually. And there's a great scene where he talks to a worker at the government agency who actually said to him, you know, look, you're disrespecting yourself, woman, you know, by taking this name Bucky, which was, you know, of many generations, an offensive term for a person of colour. So he actually creates the guy's a Battlestar and becomes Battlestar later on in the comics. Now, as we've seen in the Disney Plus series, Lamar Hoskins starts as Battlestar, and there we go, you can see there's his Battlestar costume in there. So So their partnership throughout the series, they are very much having to undergo, as they are in the series now, they are taking on government missions and taking down what is a government agenda. It's very unlike Steve Rogers. So that obviously brings some direct conflict in terms of what, you know, Steve Rogers and his ideals and what he feels he should be doing against what the government wanted to do. But John Walker is happy to do that and try and carve out his own identity as Captain America. Throughout the series, we then find what's happened to Steve Rogers, because he goes AWOL for a couple of issues, and he then comes back in the guise of the Captain. He gets a different costume, which you see here, this really cool black version with the red and white stripes, Star Spangled Stripes going the opposite way, going horizontal, not vertical, I don't know which way is which. That's horizontal, that's vertical, so he has the vertical, no he doesn't. What am I talking about? He has the horizontal stripes on his top gun that way. This really cool black costume. He gets a shield from Iron Man, Tony Stark, who at this time is wearing the super cool, super awesome Silver Centurion armor. More on that in a minute. So he gets a shield from him. And he goes underway with some of his team. He joins up with Nomad and D-Man and Falcon, Sam Wilson, the guys of the Falcon then. And he goes off, you know, trying to represent his own ideals of best serving his country and, you know, best fighting crime as he can. Now, that ultimately starts to bring those two stories of the two caps, the Captain and Captain America, begin to merge together. John Walker gets outed as Captain America by a couple of former associates of his and Lamar's. They out his identity publicly. They tell about where his family live. And that brings him up against a ultra right wing group called the Watchdogs, who are, you know, sort of, you know, anti pornography, anti any kind of sin, any kind of you know, sort of impurity. So it brings him up against him, who he's had a clash with in previous issues. Brings him up against him, and spoiler alert: make sure if you're not read of this yet, say something like that. That has some very serious personal consequences for John Walker and his family. So it starts to tip his mind over the edge of it. He's already questioning his role in terms of, you know, is this what he should be doing? Is he fighting the right fight? So the government asking him to fight the right fight. So it starts to question that. And then his mind slowly starts to unhinge in terms of a number of these sort of personal traumas and these sort of personal battles coming to the forefront. And very much seems like behind the scenes, as we start to see throughout the issues, that the head of the government commission who appointed him has a very different agenda. And that's something that very much comes to the forefront of this storyline. We haven't seen that within the Falcon and Winter Soldier, and I don't believe in any way we're going to see where it ends up. More about that in a minute. So in terms of Steve Rogers as the Captain, he's obviously fighting his own fight. Now what he finds is he gets drawn back into a number of personal battles of his own. He ends up going against Iron Man, who at the time that this story is running, is actually fighting his own personal battles, going around and taking away the armor of a number of superpowered villains that are using his technology that was stolen from him by the Spymaster and sold by Justin Hammer to his enemies. So that's Armor Wars, which again we've already covered on this show, which is freaking brilliant. And we've got an Armor Wars version coming on Disney Plus with Don Cheadle as War Machine. So that'd be again another hybrid app. So it brings Tony and the Captain Steve into conflict. Very much to start, and again, something we've seen, you know, throughout the MCU in terms of their journey of their conflicts through Civil War and Avengers Infinity War. It very much brings them into conflict because the Iron Man is going to attack the Guardsmen, who are the armored guards of the Vault, which is a super prison that hides super criminal, that keeps super criminals in prison. So Iron Man is going to take those down to basically, you know, negate their armors, and Steve tries to stop him. Now during that, Iron Man accidentally releases all of the prisoners out there, and he ends up having a clash with Steve, and he betrays Steve. He sort of gives him a mild electrocution to stop Steve, to prevent him from being able to stop him carrying out his work to destroy the armors with the tech that's been stolen. So that leads him into a big clash and a big fallout. He then gets a second shield from T'Challa, the Black Panther, and this is the second shield. It's really cool. Black, red with a star in the middle of the shield. The original shield that he gets from Iron Man, from Tony Stark, is just a plain silver, made of adamantium, plain silver, almost as good as his first shield. This equally has got more of a vibranium feel to it because it comes from Wakanda, Black Panther mate. So he's got that shield. So the two stories start to merge, as we say. This ends up with a whole conspiracy in the background. Is are the Serpent Society, who we're not going to see, I don't believe, in the Falcon and Winter Soldier Disney Plus series, who Steve Rogers, as the captain, is looking to bring down as they're plotting to overthrow Washington and DC and take over by killing the president and poisoning the water supply in Washington and turn everyone into reptiles. And then you've got Captain America, John Walker's storyline converging with his attacks from the Watchdogs. He has a number of other terror groups that he goes up against, tried to shut down, and with his own mental instability. And that brings him into conflict with Flag Smasher. Now, Flag Smasher in the comics is the leader of Ultimatum, which is a very complicated acronym, but basically that is the group, the Flag Smashers, that we're seeing in Falcon and Winter Soldier series. Now, Carly Morgenthau, as anyone who's watched Falcon and Winter Soldier, is the leader of the Flag Smashers, and Carl Morgenthau was Flag Smasher, leader of Ultimatum, in the comic book series. So there's a gender change there in terms of the character, which I don't have any issue with at all, to be honest, in doing that. Here is Flag Smasher. So Flag Smasher himself in the comics. And now, we've been a running villain of Captain America's. He's about unifying nations and bringing down corruption in government, but he has very different, almost terrorist ways of doing it. There's Flag Smasher. Really cool costume. Love that costume. Bit sort of Space Ghost, for anyone that knows Space Ghost costume. We're obviously not seeing that with Carly Morgenthau in the Falcon and Winter Soldier series. But again, lots of parallels in terms of the way these stories are merging, with John Walker looking to bring them down, Steve Rogers obviously fighting his own battles as well. So these stories end up coming together. We find out behind the scenes that the Red Skull, a returned Red Skull, which again, I don't think is going to happen in this series at all. We find out that a returned Red Skull has been manipulating the government commission, and he's got paid, you know, bribery and corruption with the senior officer who appointed John Walker. And basically, he's put in John Walker thinking that he knows that there's this unstable side of him, and he's engineered all these terror groups against him, all these problems, to basically create an unstable John Walker, Captain America, to tarnish forever the reputation and image of Captain America, obviously with the Red Skull being a, you know, fascist that wants to tear down the American government and their way of life. So that's who's in the background behind all that. I don't expect to see any of that element in the Falcon and Winter Soldier Disney Plus series, but that's where this heads in this story. So we end up, obviously, you'd expect, when former Captain America Steve Rogers, the captain, finds out about some of the, you know, terrible things under extreme pressure that John Walker has been doing. John Walker is a bit more of a fascist himself in the comic book, and they've not painted him that way. He's a lot harder to like in the comic book series than he is in the TV series. They made him a more sort of complex character in the Disney Plus series. But it brings those two obviously into conflict at the end, as they find out who's behind these schemes. And it's awesome. And as you can see from the cover there, you've got a brilliant, you know, the original Cap. Let's find some of the pages there. The original Cap up against the new captain, you know, glorious fight scenes going on between the two for the battle for the shield. And ultimately it ends up with who will prove the worst, who will end up taking on the shield at the end. Now, I've tried not to ruin too much of that. There's a few spoilers in there. If you haven't read that, I heartily recommend that. That's available trade paperback now. You can get it on the Marvel Unlimited app. But I definitely give that a read. That's Captain America issues 332 to 350. You'll find them back in sort of 1985, 1986. You'll find those on the Marvel Unlimited app, or you'll find that trade paperback. And the original series was, as I say, titled Captain America No More by Mark Grunwald and Kieran Dwyer. So that is awesome, awesome series. And that is our Marvel must read for this episode, which hopefully you've enjoyed. Hopefully that inspires you to go and read that. And if it does, and you want to look at some of our other episodes, then by all means do go back across our channel, have a look at some of those now. We've got loads more of that stuff, a lot of Marvel Legends stuff on there as well, a lot of other things with TV, movies for Marvel and the comics. So I hope you enjoy that. If you enjoyed this, give that a little like and a thumbs up. Thank you very much. And if you're not subscribed, if you could do that as well, that'd be amazing. Thank you so much. So that's it from this episode. Thanks very much. See you again next time.